Okay, here we are back in Disgaea. Where we last left off, we met with Don Joaquin, and, well, we're on the precipice of war. So, let's begin. This is the Stellar Graveyard, if I remember correctly.
Episode 12, War of the Netherworld, Part 1.
And if you notice, there was no lead into this, which should tell you how messed up things are.
What was that?
Felt like an earthquake, but they barely ever happen around here.
But whenever there's one, something big always happens. I wonder what catastrophe will happen this time.
An invasion.
Prince! Several giant objects have appeared at the Stellar Graveyard, dude!
That was quick. How many?
Dude, there are billions of them!
You hear that, Jennifer? The EDF is here to save us! We can go home!
Wait, Gordon. We can't be so sure. Even if it was the EDF, why would they send so many ships?
Oh, come on! Why are you being so pessimistic? It's not like you!
Well, why don't we go check it out?
I agree. Sitting here won't do any good.
All right, then, to the Stellar Graveyard!
So, to add in on what Gordon was saying, he does have a point how Jennifer's character has significantly changed, and there is a little bit of reason for that, but still a little disjarring. It's been a while since the last natural disaster. Let's see, there was the time when the king was so happy that the queen accepted his proposal, he knocked over a few mountains. The time when the king was so thrilled that the prince was born, he froze the ocean. And the time when the king was so sad because of the queen's passing, he split the earth in two. Wouldn't you consider those to be artificial disasters? Is it me, or are the humans overshadowing you, Prince? No, they're not. It's just you. Let's hope so. But right there, he is hinting at one of the complaints about the game. Like, for the second half of the game, it's like we're playing a different game altogether. The first half was about Laharl's rise to the throne, and then now that he is Overlord, all of a sudden we're playing Gordon's story. I know some people aren't happy about that, but... What could those unidentified objects be? Space battlecruisers? Giant robots? Well, the way things have been going lately, they could be just about anything, I'd say. I've always loved sci-fi stories.
Prince, I'm going to the bathroom, okay?
I had to replay Chapter 11. I hope I went in here and read the promise. But in case you don't remember, this is when Krzyzewski had left the request for Laharl to... or for Enna to raise Laharl. So, Chapter 12. Stolen memories. My precious memory. The dying words of the king. I'd protect the prince. Not long after I made that promise, my memories were stolen. I don't know if he knew of my promise, but it was Medeiros who stole my memories and plotted to take over the throne. He proposed a deal to me. If I wanted my memories back, I had to kill the prince. It's ironic that in my stolen memories was my promise to protect the prince. But I had no choice. Since when was the Netherworld open to the public? Who cares? It's more fun this way. Those giant unidentified objects are in the Stellar Graveyard, too. Since we don't know what's there, do whatever tickles your fancy. So, I think my team is good to rumble. We've detected objects in the Stellar Graveyard, too. I feel great power. Prince, be careful. There's no power greater than mine. Just relax and wait for my return. Embryon. Now, if you... Yes. Do I have to... Okay, then he's done. So if you want this job class, you have to have a gunner with level 20 gun mastery. It can take some time, but there are certain jobs that are easier to do than others. But all things considered, these guys aren't really that exceptional, and if you don't want them, don't sweat it. You're not really missing much. They don't count towards the mod gene, if I remember correctly.
Soldiers of the EDF, I told you, Jennifer, just like I said.
I've never seen so many humans all at once.
So, what'd they come all the way here for?
To ruin your neighborhood.
Aren't they here to rescue Mr. Gordon?
Or trash the Netherworld?
Don't you think they're acting kind of strange, though?
What's wrong? Your beloved hero is right here!
By the way, if you're wondering why they're wearing helmets and Gordon isn't, they're cyborgs. That's pretty much the only justification. Graphic-wise, it's probably because the animators didn't want to make a bunch of different faces, and they just decided to write it off as the whole cyborg thing, but now you know.
Hey, guys! It's me, Captain Gordon, Defender of Earth!
Not very popular, are you?
That he isn't.
Poor Mr. Gordon.
Don't be silly. I'm the Defender of Earth. All the kids love me.
But do you have a Saturday morning cartoon show?
I had my own comic series and Saturday morning cartoon.
Well, that answers that.
But they don't seem all that impressed.
Gordon, we've been used.
Used? What do you mean, Jennifer?
They asked us to defeat the Overlord, but their true purpose was to secure a route to the Netherworld.
What are you saying, Jennifer? They're risking their lives to save us. How can you accuse them of...
But, Gordon, can't you see?
Enough of this. I don't want to hear it. I'm shocked and disappointed in you. I hereby dismiss you from your duties as my assistant.
Going a bit far?
I see.
I must have faith in the people of Earth. Unfaltering, unwavering faith. It's my duty as Defender of Earth. Right, guys?
It's one thing to have faith in the people, and a completely other thing to have faith in the government.
Captain Gordon, Defender of Earth, you are to be terminated.
What?
Sucks to be you.
All the kids love me, huh? Right.
Let's face it, Gordon had it coming.
Poor Mr. Gordon.
Die.
Hey, wait! What are you doing?
So if you look, we have the geo effect here where you take damage for staying inside the green tiles. And these guys should all be packing guns because that's their forte. This guy has a silver tux. You can see he has 400, pretty much 500 defense, we'll say, but their resistance is really, really bad. So if you have magic users, this is when they can really shine. To give you a small example, you are weak to wind. And that's how they go down. Fortunately, this guy might live just because I don't have Giga Ice. Problem solved. So we're gonna put her over here. And as you can see, you can walk across the green tiles, it's just you don't want to end your turn on them. Wait a second, what are they weak to? Ice? Let's do it. We're gonna combo them with a double mega ice. The one on higher ground might live. Yep, he did. You, on the other hand, you are weak to fire. That's kind of unfortunate for you. Now that I notice, Well, now that I think about it, I never looked at their levels. Oh, this guy is kind of durable, isn't he? Yeah. Oh, okay, he's one of the resistant types. So, level 44, my guys have a slight level advantage, but the equipment advantage is diminishing. Counter, counter, counter. Okay, let's roll out. Gonna send these two over here. Lucky he'll die, if not, then I'll have the archer finish him. Just remember, folks, the only problem with brute force is when you don't have enough of it. Now, how many are left? You're weak to ice. Damn it. I probably should look into leveling up the Ice Mage so that I can kill these things a little bit more easily. Whoa. Okay, yeah, Flan hurts. And you know what? I'm gonna try to steal that Silver Tux. And I messed this up. Oh, Gordon here. Him here. Okay, Jennifer. So, is this worth anything? You've got two attacks, you can look at it. That's pretty nice. It's gonna be a significant upgrade to whoever I give it to. And now let's see if there's an EXP reward. Nope, stabby knife. He's weak to fire. Finishing blow, the coup de grace.
Booyah! Why would the EDF attack me?
Duh, they stabbed you in the back. You're slow.
Beep, beep, blip, beep. Captain Gordon, incoming message from General Carter.
Ah, Gordon! I see that you're still alive. What? With your help securing a route, we were able to make it here unchallenged. Now, the Netherworld will be ours. I thank you, defenders of Earth. Oh my god! We were being used!
And he just now gets it.
Are you just realizing that now?
Aren't you happy, Flan? There's someone even dumber than you!
I knew of their plan all along!
Liar!
Gordon, you were a splendid pawn. I will tell the people of Earth that Captain Gordon died valiantly while fighting the Overlord. It's the least I can do for you. Well then, Gordon, so long.
There are some promising humans out there.
I was thinking the same thing. Should we try to recruit him?
Will you stop joking around? This is a serious matter!
Jennifer?
She's probably hurt because you trusted them instead of her. Oh well, it's none of my business.
Didn't you dismiss her just a minute ago, Gordon?
Aww. Poor Miss Jennifer.
Jennifer, about that dismissal...
It's okay, Gordon. I deserve to be dismissed.
Jennifer...
Thursday, not the one to blame. All Gordon's fault.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Jennifer.
And that concludes the first level. So now I have to figure out who I want to put this piece of armor on. Wow, she has a 250... Okay, it's definitely not her. Now I need the Arms Master there. We'll put it on Jessica. I probably should look into getting the Arms Master off of that sometime. And I'll worry about correcting my inventory later. Into core point number 4.
Long time no see, Gordon.
Who's there? Curtis?
That's right, Curtis, Defender of Earth.
How cool! A rival has made his appearance! Look, look!
Yeah, calm down.
My goal was to defeat you, Gordon, but it seems I've overestimated you.
Huh? What do you mean?
I assumed that you had completed your mission and defeated the Overlord. I came here to settle things with you. But look at the facts. You failed your mission, and even worse, you've become the Overlord's slave.
I think he prefers the term vassal.
I'm embarrassed to call you my rival.
He's right. That is embarrassing.
And Laharl's quick to kick someone when they're down.
You don't have the right to call yourself Defender of Earth, nor the right to fight me. So long.
Curtis, wait. You're right. I didn't complete my mission. And in your eyes, it may seem that my current predicament is rather pathetic.
What's he talking about? It is pathetic.
Getting good.
But I say, I have not lost my passion. I still have a hero's spirit. Words cannot describe the sensation. My soul burns brighter than ever before. And do you know why? Because the true enemy has appeared before my very eyes.
Fine then. If you insist, prove me wrong.
Save it.
I'll be waiting for you, Captain Gordon. Don't lose to these bunch of soldiers.
So if you notice, you end your turn on a green panel, you die. And as for the red panels, you can't cast any spells. So these guys are packing axes instead. They're all packing silver tuxes, too. I probably should spend a little while here just buying hands and coming back to steal some armor. In case you're hurting for money and you need to do that, that is a legitimate strategy, don't worry. But for the time being, I'm just going to bring her out and have her defend. We'll see if any of them will come to us first. Here they come. And in case you're wondering, yes, they can step on the green panels without any sort of punishment because it only affects my team. Also, don't put your back to the green panels because they can stand on these and then cast skills. You're already going to have a rough time because they... Well... For one, they have the numbers advantage. Hopefully that's a little self-explanatory. Secondary problem is that you need to kind of force them down like I'm doing here. You want to usually focus fire to guarantee a kill on one of them, and in a perfect world, you'd actually have someone over here to serve as kind of like a bottleneck or distraction or something. But unfortunately, I never got around to creating my scout, and I don't really use my knight, so I'm a little pressed for guys to absorb damage without bringing out Laharl. He only has 100 defense. Ouch. So let's defend, because odds are they're going to come for him. The important thing is they're not building up a combo gauge. Now, if you do want to be really dirty, you do have this option. So, let's say I want to kill this guy and this guy. They're both weak to wind. Ah. Why can't I lift? Well, if I have to sacrifice Flan, oh well. But the way this is supposed to work is that you put someone on the green panels, cast a spell with them, have someone from the red panel pick them up, and then throw them to safety. Like that. I'm actually going to put her back-to-back with the, Rogue. I should be able to kill him with a counterattack. This way, neither of them can get back attacked. I kind of wish you could see the stats and the specialists there on these tuxes, but well. Let's grab that one. Now if I wanted to put it on her... This one makes you very resistant to magic. Actually, I don't want to put that on her now that I think about it. The one that I want to put this on is Emily. And if you're wondering why, the cryophile here should amplify her ice spells, so she's not as pitiful with them as she used to be. Face this way so you don't need an axe move. And how many are left? 4. I know about the one guy over here, don't worry. It's just, he's gonna die. How, you ask? I'm gonna lift him up. We'll throw him over here. Then we're gonna pile on. They didn't even need the archer. Now the gunners... I thought they'd start coming down, but oh well. Can I lift one up, or are they too high? Odds are they're going to kill the rogue next turn, but I can live with that. I do need to rack up more deaths just to get some better equipment. Booyah! Oh. That was a little unexpected. Anyway, I'm just gonna fall back a bit. We'll see if he moves. I'm gonna try to make my way over here. Turn, we can end this. Actually, I'm gonna have the rogue throw. I forgot to put the Ice Mage out to collect that EXP. Oh well. No prizes. Star Cluster. Dance for me, you foolish humans. You'll save me the trouble of dealing with both Flan and the Overlord. Ingenious, if I do say so myself. All that remains is that spineless Seraph. Once I get rid of him, I will be the one and only. Humans, demons, angels, I will be the god of all. What's wrong? You're acting weird. I felt an evil presence. Was it General Carter? Maybe Curtis? No, it wasn't human. Something more terrifying. It's hard to believe that there's something more evil than me. Are you sure you're not imagining things? Maybe it's just me. So if you notice, you take damage here, and everything here is invincible. Your alternative is to fight on the enemy boost tiles, which are necessary for survival. Now, I don't know if you can step on these, but you can see that the hard part here is you have to fight on the green. And you have to pull the enemy in there before you get a chance. Usually this is one of those maps where I would recommend just getting some characters really, really strong and then brute forcing your way through. But we'll handle this one way or another. So we're going to put her here, and we're going to put her on defend. This should pull these guys into the blue, or green. Wind, ice, fire, sun. Okay, I'm gonna hit them with a fire spell. If I wanna hit them with a I can't use Omega Fire. I can use Giga Fire, though. So we'll park her here. She can't use it. Flan, here you go. I'm So right here I'm popping Knights Ever to try to kill him. Or at least weaken him enough for the archer to finish the job, and it looks like it was enough for a one-hit kill. Their move. Worth pointing out is if you look at their level 44, it's consistent with all the other guys up until this point, and if you're wondering why, it is because of the enemy boost tiles. I feel like I should point that out, just in case you didn't notice it yourself. And I'm gonna need the rogue out. Going to defend just in case they start shooting. And I'm actually going to fall back here. Grab this one, throw him here, and then burn him down. Weak to fire. Well, this is a good time to practice Omega Fire, but I need to move a little differently. We're going to put her here, and she needs to stand where Flan is standing. He's weak to ice. And we need to get a mega heal out. I should also point out one other thing about this level, since it can screw you. So in the event you wanted to get rid of the enemy boost panels, if you notice the geo symbol here, it's red. So if you were to pop this, that means the entire map, all tiles become invincible and they will take a fifth of your health every turn. So if you destroy this geo panel where it is, it's game over. There's no way to win the map anymore. And then I don't remember if there's actually a way to pop the invincibility, maybe with the scout or something, but I don't have it, so just make sure not to fall for that trap. We're going to hit this guy with Night Sever. This should kill him. Now we're going to kill this guy. I need to move my rogue into position. And I know some of you are probably saying, in position for what? Well, you'll see. Oops. That's money, that's a reward here. Oh well. Now, if you're wondering why I moved the road, can't believe that. And the next person to go is going to be our Lady Warrior. Other than Flan, the mages probably can't actually make the trip. So you have 5 spaces that you can move, you can reach this square. They move 4 spaces, Flan does move 5. The archer can go also, and I'll send Flan next turn. But in the meantime, let's see if we can start pulling them closer to us. Oh, we got the gunner. But hopefully, seeing this geo set up here, you'll realize the game has kind of taken the gloves off, and if you're not careful, you really can screw yourself. Fall back to here. We'll move her up, and we're gonna Knight Sever in the face. Ah, I'm out of SP. He's got a gritty vest. And I forgot to move Flan, I just realized. Yeah, she's not making the trip this turn. Can I shoot him? No. He's gonna counter again. Change of plan. I kind of need to heal them. Still move her since I canceled her move. Which allows me to bring in her. Their turn. Wrong one. Don't want to heal the enemy. And the guy in the corner should die when this is all said and done. Well, if those counterattacks keep hitting for less than 150, he might live. Yeah. Sturm Himmelim. Not like I can hit any allies with it, so why not? And I'm actually going to use Sturm Himmel here. Because that way I'll have a combo. I'm gonna step back. Since he's paralyzed, he's not going anywhere. Let's move her back two spaces. Hit this guy with King of Beasts. Keep in mind, with Flan, I can just instantly kill him with a spell. Sidereal Rift.
Miss Jennifer has been really depressed lately.
I wonder whose fault that is.
Me too.
Don't look at me like that.
You should apologize.
Yeah? Jennifer? Well, you see...
It's all my fault.
What?
I could have stopped them, but I didn't. I knew what was happening, but I kept denying it. If only I was stronger.
What do you mean, Jennifer? What are you talking about?
Who's there?
Well done, Overlord. I thought I had completely masked my presence.
You do. Getting this close without me noticing.
It's an honor to hear such praise from you. My purpose was to settle things with Gordon, but now you've caught my attention.
And what have you got in mind?
You ask the obvious. Mono a mono. We shall speak with our fists.
So if you didn't get the gist of that, here's Curtis. Level 52. You'll notice he's packing a panda claw for a weapon, hero cape, gritty vest. He has his three moves there. He does get a fourth one later on. I'm not gonna give you all the details, but he and Thursday, I think, are the only story characters that get four moves, but that's because they do use monster weapons. So I wanted to see if anyone's using a gritty vest, know if I should steal his stuff or not. Is there one in here? Probably should have unloaded some stuff to get some more hands, but oh well. Poison Nickel is the reward. Legendary Power Jacket. That is kind of tempting. Legendary Muscle Victory. But yeah, these guys, you'll notice there are no geo panels or anything in play. As such, they're significantly easier to take down. Use Weak to Wind. And he is not a resistant type. leave James lingering in the background. Emily and Jessica are out. And their turn. Aw, man. This is gonna hurt Flan. Ouch. 45. Nope, can't reach him. So I'll stab this guy in the back. This has to do over 500 to have a chance to kill him. He survives. Now without Zielrigan, I can't shoot both of them with my archer. And she's not even really that close to getting it either. I can Delta shot it, or Delta split. They're both weak to ice. I'm moving Flan so I can move James over here to get the kill. You're weak to wind. Okay, we'll use the 6-point spell. Not ideal, but it's still going to increase the overall damage dealt this turn. Damn. Looks like one of those guys is resistant. Never mind, he died. I'm holding back. I could bring out Edna, but she's way behind. Flan's dead. Nope, they sell for Emily instead. Damn. We're going to use Gigawind here. Execute them with Blade Rush. Crap. Actually, no, Jessica has to use Giga Heal because she's not that good of a healer yet. As much as I'd like to go for the gunner guy, I need to send her here. And her here.
Booyah! It's all down! Booyah!
Hey!
It says the hero cape is better than the gritty vest. Do I have anyone using a hero cape? Wow, Wow. Yeah, I'm going for that. Yeah, very nice. I'll use Gigafire because I want to upgrade the spell some. Then we'll go over here and use Rising Dragon. That should be good to end the turn. Only one enemy should die this turn, though. This guy should survive. Down he goes. Anyway, that should be the end of the fight.
Ready to get serious, but I don't want to injure the VIP.
What? Who's he talking about?
Has he fallen in love with me? Oh, sweet.
Where'd you get that idea?
What the? Why is the ground shaking? That's the space battleship Gargantua!
I mentioned this in an earlier video, now you know what I was talking about.
We will now begin a full-scale attack with over 2 million battleships, but before that... Your father awaits you, Jennifer. Come with me.
Father? I thought her parents passed away when she was a child.
What? You didn't know? She is General Carter's foster child.
What?
I'm sorry, Gordon. What Curtis said is true. I was adopted by General Carter and raised as his child. He was a kind man. I always believed that he loved me. But that couldn't have been further from the truth. He raised me only so he could use me.
If you're going to complain about your father, tell him yourself. My orders are simply to bring you back alive.
He wants to use me again? It doesn't matter anymore.
Wait! Jennifer, don't go! You're the assistant of Captain Gordon, Defender of Earth! Remember? Have you forgotten our sworn duty?
Didn't you dismiss her?
Right.
Shut up! Don't dig up the past! I retracted that! Jennifer, it doesn't matter if you're Carter's daughter or not. As the assistant to the Defender of Earth, listen to your heart! What is right? What do you believe in? And what will you do right now?
Gordon.
Enough talk. Gordon, Overlord, I'd like to settle this once and for all. If you want Jennifer back, then find a way aboard the Gargantua. Until then, see ya.
Jennifer! Jennifer!
To be continued.
Episode 12, War of the Netherworld, Part 1, End. So let's go ahead and save.